Good morning, children. Now we have our maths class. Hope you all go through the topics that we discussed yesterday. Which topic we discussed yesterday? We discussed 7-digit numbers. Do you remember what all things we discussed yesterday? 7-digit, or the place value chart of a 7-digit number, then how to write a 7-digit number, how to write the number name of a 7-digit number, then if a 7-digit number is given, how to write the number, how to write the numeral of a 7-digit number, all we discussed yesterday. Just we have a quick review of these topics that we already learned yesterday. So once again, a 7-digit number, do you remember which is the smallest 7-digit number? The smallest 7-digit number is 10 lakh. The smallest 7-digit number is 10 lakh. Then what is the place value chart of the Indian place value system, or the place value chart of a 7-digit number? And when a 7-digit number is given, we divide the numeral into groups, which we call as periods. And these periods, starting from the right end, we group the number into periods of 3, or in the group of 3, 2, 2, and so on. So the right end period is 1's period, then 1's period, then we have 1000's period, 1000's period, then we have lakh's period. Again, these periods are again divided into 3 places, which we call which the ones period are divided into 3 places, which are ones, tens, hundreds. Thousands periods are divided into 2 thousands, 10 thousands. I'm using short form for representing thousands, 10 thousands, etc. Then lakhs period is again divided into lakhs and 10 lakhs, which we call it as the places. Just a quick review. So how to represent a number in a place value chart? For that, I'll give an example. First number, what about 10 lakh? How to represent this 10 lakh in a place value chart? Starting from the right end, we have to put the digit at the right end of the number at 1's place, then again 0 in the 10's place, 100 in the 0 in the 100's place, again 0 in the 1000's place, 0 in the 10,000's place, 0 in the lakhs place, and 1 in the 10 lakhs place. Now coming to another number, okay, this number, this is a 7-digit number, this number you can represent in the place value chart. Starts from the right end, the 1 in the 1's place, 3 in the 10's place, 9 in the 100's place, 7 in the 1000's place, 3 in the 10,000's place, 2 in the lakhs place, and 4 in the 10 lakhs place. Again, next, after that we learn how to write the number name, or how to read a 7-digit number. The same example we will consider. 4237931 is a 7-digit number. to read a number, to read a seven digit number, to write the number name of a seven digit number, first we have to group according to the periods. First group of ones period separated by comma, then again thousands period separated by comma. Now in so we have these seven digit numbers. First group consists of the starting from the right end. The first group ones period have three digits, thousands period have two digits, and lakhs period again have two digits. Which these periods, to represent these periods are separated by commas. Now, how will you read this period, or how will you read this number? When you read a number, we have to read the digits of a particular period together along with their period name. So when you consider the first period 42, the digits in the first period, lakhs period, have 4 and 2 taken together 42. We have to write it as, or we can read it as 42 lakh, then 37,000, then the last period have three digits which have to read together as 931. Okay, again, the next process, so I think you remember all these things. Whenever we read a number, we have to read together each period along with the period name. Now, another case, if a number name is given, if it is 90 lakh, and 90 lakh and 9. If a number 90 lakh and 9, a number name is given, how to convert this to a numeral? We know a seven digit number has three periods. The first period is the lakhs period, which consists of two digits, which, and here it is 90 lakh, so you have to represent 90 lakh, then put the comma. Then the next period, think of the next period, which is the next period, it is thousands period. But thousands period is not here, that means if a period is not given in the number name, we have to put zeros for that, that is the thousands period. Two zeros, because each period have two digits in each period, so we have to put two zeros. And the last period is ones period, but also here ones period, there is only 9 in the ones period is given in the number name. So what we can do here, you have to represent 9 as a 3 digit number. How will you represent this 9 as a 3 digit number? It is 009. Up to here we discussed yesterday. So I think you all remember all these things. Now we will move to the 8-digit numbers. So 8-digit number, and along with the 8-digit number, we just go through 9-digit numbers also. So coming to the 8-digit numbers, first of all, how will you obtain an 8-digit number? Which is the largest 7-digit number? The largest 7-digit number is 99,99,999. The largest 7-digit number is 99,99,999. So after the largest 7-digit number, which will be the next number? It will be the smallest 8-digit number. So how will you obtain this smallest 8-digit number? Add 1 to this largest 7-digit number. When you add 1 to this largest 7-digit number, you are getting the smallest 8-digit number. Smallest 8-digit number, which we call it as 1 crore. The smallest 8-digit number, which we call it as 1 crore. Now, what we are going to learn is the place value system or the place value chart of an 8-digit number, then how to write a number name of an 8-digit number, how to write the numeral if the number name is given for an 8-digit number. Now, first of all, let us consider the place value, Indian place value chart of an 8-digit number. Place value chart of an 8-digit number. Whenever we write the place value, or whenever we learn the place value chart of any number, any numeral in Indian place value system, we have to group the numbers according to the periods, starting from the right end, and the right end consists of 3 digits, then all other groups will have 2 digits each. So if we consider an 8-digit number, we have 2, 3, 4. It's an 8-digit number. Whenever you have an 8-digit number, we have to group that 8-digit number according to the periods. For that, first of all, we have to learn which are the periods involved in an 8-digit number. So the periods involved in an 8-digit number are, the first period is ones period. Then the next period is thousands period, same as 7-digit number, thousands period. Then the next period is lakhs period, L-A-K-H-S, lakhs period. And then comes to the crores period, C-R-O-R-E-S, crores period. So in an 8-digit number or a 9-digit number, we have 4 periods. Which are the 4 periods? Ones period, thousands period, lakhs period, and crores period. Again, likewise, as we learned in 7-digit number, the ones period is divided into 3. Which are the 3 places for ones period? It is ones, tens, hundreds. Let us use O for ones, T for tens, and H for hundreds. Then, for thousands period is again divided into 2 places, which have thousand and 10,000. Then lakhs period is also divided into 2, which are lakhs place and 10 lakhs place. Now coming to the crores period. Crores period are also divided into 2, which can be written as crores and 10 crores. 10 crores, which can be denoted by C and capital 10 C. Okay, so once again, for an 8-digit number, we have, in the place value chart of an 8-digit number, we have 4 periods, which are the 4 periods? Ones period, thousands period, lakhs period, and crores period. Again, each periods are again divided into places. Which are the places? The first place, first period, ones period is divided into three places: ones place, tens place, hundreds place. Thousands period is divided into two places: thousands place and ten thousands place. Lakhs period is divided into lakhs place and ten lakhs place. Crores period is divided into crores place and ten crores place. Now, to represent how to represent a number, a numeral in the place value chart of an 8-digit number. How to represent a numeral in the place value chart of a eight-digit number? Okay, let us consider which is the first 8-digit number we learn. It is 1 crore. 1 crore have 7 zeros. 1 crore have 7 zeros. 7 zeros. So in this case, how to represent this 1 crore in a place value, in a place value chart? Starting from the right end, ones place in 1 crore, the digit in the ones place is 0. Then digit in the tens place is also 0. Digit in the hundreds place is 0. Digit in the thousands place is 0. Digit in the ten thousands place is 0. Lakhs place is 0. 10 lakhs place is 0. And last, the crores place, the digit in the crores place is 1. So this is how you can represent any number, any 8-digit number in a place value chart. Now we'll move to another number. Let us consider another 8-digit number. This is an 8-digit number. How to represent this 8-digit number on the place value chart? From the right end, starting from the right end, the first digit is 9 in the ones place, 5 in the hundreds place, 5 in the tens place, 1 in the hundreds place, 0 in the thousands place, 7 in the ten thousands place, 2 in the lakhs place, 3 in the 10 lakhs place, and again 3 in the crores place. So whenever an 8-digit number is given, we can represent that in a place value chart, starting from the, not 8-digit number, any numbers, any 7-digit number, any 8-digit number, any 3, any 5-digit number, any 4-digit number, any numeral can be represented on a place value chart. But remember, we have to start writing from the right end, the right end digit should write at the ones place. Starting from there, you have to complete. Is that clear, all of you? So once again, from the beginning of the 8-digit number, how will you obtain an 8-digit number? We can obtain an 8-digit number from largest 7-digit number by adding 1 to the largest 7-digit number. And we got the smallest 8-digit number, which we call it as 1 crore. Then, coming to the place value chart or the Indian place value system of an 8-digit number, we have 4 periods: ones period, thousands period, lakhs period and crores period. Thousands period are divided into 3 places: ones, tens, hundreds. Sorry, ones period is divided into three places, ones, tens, hundreds. Thousands period are divided into two places, thousands, ten thousands. Lakhs period are divided into again into two places, lakhs, ten lakhs. And crores period are also divided into two places, crores and 10 crores. But for an 8-digit number, we are using only crores. For 9-digit number, we are using 10 crores also. Okay. Now, moving on to how to write a numeral, how to write the number name of an 8-digit number. How to write the number name of an 8-digit numeral. So, this is an 8-digit numeral. To write an 8-digit numeral, to write the number name of an 8-digit numeral, we have to group the numeral into 3, 2, 2, 2 and so on, starting from the right end. So, first of all, the right end has 9 as the digit. Starting from the right end, we consider we have to group into 3 which belongs to the ones period. Which belongs to the ones period. Is that clear? From the right end, the first 3 belongs to the one right belongs to ones period. To represent that period, we have to separate each period by commas. Then coming to the next period is thousands period, which thousands period which consists of only 2 digits. Then coming to the lakhs period, we have only 2 digits. Lakhs period also have the 2 digits, 32. And the last come to the crores period. Crores period, since it is an 8-digit number, in crores period we have only 1 digit, and that is 3 in the crores period. So, once again, when you write the number name, to write a number name, first of all, we have to separate the periods starting from ones period, then thousands, lakhs and crores. Now, how will you read this number? So, whenever we read a number, very, very, very important. Whenever we read a number, we have to read or we have to write the digits of a particular period together along with the period name. So, in this number, the first period is crores period. Crores period have only one digit, that is 3. So, you can read or write the number name as 3 crore. 3 crore. Now coming to the next period is 3-2 belongs to the lakhs period. 3-2 belongs to the lakhs period. So we have to read that 3-2 together, the digits together as 32 along with the period name. So it is 32 lakhs. 32 lakhs. Then the next period is thousands period, which has the digits, have the digits 7 and 0. So we have to read it together as 70. We have to read it as 70. So it is 70 lakh. 70 lakh. Sorry, 70,000. Sorry. Seventy thousand 100, and the last period is 159 belongs to the ones period, but no need to read that 159 together as 159, but as an exceptional case in the last period, no need to represent that ones period name along with the number. So it is 159. 159. I think you understood. Just like what we learned yesterday, the same procedure we are doing in this one also, but we have one more period that also you have to represent. Now another number we have. To write this, write the number name of this 8-digit number, of this 8-digit number. So before writing an 8-digit number, we have to group this one as a group of 3, 2, 2 and 2 and so on. Then again starting from the first cross period, it has only 9 in the cross period. So it is 9 crore. Now for the next period, it has 05. Which is the number? When you read 05 together, which is that number? It is 5. So you can write it as, no need to write 05 because we have to read it together. So it is 5 lakh. It is 5 lakh. Then in the next period, it is 00. 00, no, 0 is 0. We cannot read that number 00 because since it is not a counting number, 0 is not a counting number. So in that case, no need, if 00 comes, no need to represent that period name, no need to, in the number name, no need to represent a 0000. So just leave, if 0 comes in any period, both the digits are zeros in any period, just leave that period and then go to the next period, and the next period consists of 304, which is 304. 304. So which is the number name? What is the number name of this 8-digit number? It is 9 crore 5 lakh 304. Is that clear, all of you? So this is how we can write the number name of an 8-digit number. Now, if the number name of an 8-digit number is given, for example, 3 crore 12 lakh 3005. If the number name is given, how to write the numeral of this corresponding of this respective number name? For that, we have to start from the cross period. The first period is 3 crore and in an 8-digit number, the cross period has only one digit and you have to write that 3 crore. Each period have to separate by commas, 3 crore. So it is 3 comma. Now the next period, we all know after crore it is lakhs period. So coming to the lakhs period, find out the number in the lakhs period. Which is the number in the lakhs period? It is 12. So 12 lakh. So 12 lakh. Then to represent the next period, you have to separate comma. Separate the numbers by digits by commas. Then coming to the next period is thousands period. In the thousands period, which is the number belonging to the thousands period? It is only 3. Do you understand? First coming to the crores period, it has only one digit, it is 3. Then lakhs period, it has two digits, 12 is the number in the lakhs period. So you can represent that 12 in the lakhs period. Then coming to the thousands period, we have only 3, but any period have to represent lakhs or thousands or crores period have to represent by two digits. Since we have only 3 in the thousands period, that 3 can be written as 03. You cannot write it as 30 because 30 represent another number, it is 30. So if only 3 is there, you have to represent it as 03 in the thousands period, put the comma, and the last ones period have only 5. But actually we know that ones period should have 3 digits in the hundreds place, tens place and ones place. But here we have only 5. So when you read this 5, when you write this 5 in the ones period, we have to represent as 005. We cannot use 500 because 500 is another number which is 500 in the ones period. The number here is 5 only. So when you write this 5, it is 005. So the number is 3,12,003,005. Is that clear, all of you? So another, our smallest 8-digit number one crore. How will you write the numeral for 1 crore? Only 1 crore. How will you write the number numeral 1 crore? The first period is crores period. It has only 1. So you write 1. Put the comma. Then in the place value chart, which is the next period, it's lakhs period. But in 1 crore, in the number name of the 1 crore, number name of 1 crore, no lakhs period is given there. If any period is missing, how to represent that missing period in the number, in the numeral? We have to represent by 2 zeros. So since lakhs period is missing, we have to represent that by 2 zeros. Again, now the next period in the place value chart is thousands period. Thousands period also is missing from 1 crore. So we have to represent the thousands period by 2 zeros. So crores period we have, lakhs period 00 we represent, thousands period also we represent by 00, and the ones period is also not there in 1 crore, the number name of the 1 crore. So that also can be represented by 3 zeros because ones period have 3 places. So this is the numeral for 1 crore. Similarly, what will be the numeral for 8 crore? What will be the numeral for 8 crore? 8 crore. 8 crore. Again, crores period we have 8. Lakhs period is not there, so you have to put 2 zeros because the lakhs period, we need 2 digits in the lakhs period, you have to put zeros. Thousands periods also is not there, so you have to put 2 zeros to represent the thousands period. And ones period is also have to be represented by 3 zeros. So what all things we discussed today? We learned an 8-digit number. An 8-digit number is obtained from the largest 7-digit number by adding 1 to the largest 7-digit number. Then we discussed the place value chart of an 8-digit number. The place value chart of an 8-digit number consists of 4 periods. Which are the 4 periods? Ones period, thousands period, lakhs period and crores period. Ones period is again divided into 3 places, ones, tens, hundreds. Thousands period is divided into 2, thousands, 10,000. Lakhs period divided into 2, lakhs and 10 lakhs. And crores period is also divided into crores and 10 crores. But here, since we are using only 8-digit number, we are using crores and we are not using 10 crore. Then to write the numeral, to write the number name of an 8-digit number, first we have to divide into groups of 3, 2, etc. Starting from the right end. Don't forget, it is from the right end. So the right end, the first period is ones period, then thousands period, lakhs period, crores period. When you read a number, when you write the number name, we have to read the digits of a particular period together along with the period name. So if a number name is given, if a particular period is not there, that means that period has the value 00. If it is thousands period, its value is 00. If it is ones period, it is 000. Is that clear, all of you? Now we will move to the exercise questions. You can take page 9 of your textbook, exercise 1.1. What's the first one? Write the numbers in words. Write the numbers in words. Okay, you can write in your rough book now. No need to write that in the notebook, fair notebook, you no need to write. Then I give the notes, it will be given, and you can do now you can write along me in a rough notebook. And the homework questions, when I give the homework question, that also you have to write in the notebook after writing the notes. Whatever I am giving in the in this board, in this class, from the exercise questions, that I will give along with the notes. So you can write that along with the notes in the fair notebook, but now you can write in the rough notebook. First question, 8 8 9 5 7 9 0. So to write this in words, first of all, it is a 7-digit number. What we have to do, we have to group this one. Starting from the right end, you should put commas. Now from the left end, which is the first period, this lakhs period, so it is 88 lakh. It is 88 lakh. Then what about the next period, 95? It is 95. The period name is 95,790. Okay, now can you write the next number, 9 4 5 6 8 3 4 1. Starting from the right end, you put commas so that we got 4 periods. Then from the left, we have to start with the largest period name, which is the first period, is crores period. So crores period contains only one digit, and it is 9 crore. 9 crore. 45. Lakh. 68,000. 68,000. 341. What about the next question? 5 5 2 8 3 1 0. And one more question, 3 4 5 4 1 0 0 0. So before writing the number name, first of all we have to group. Starting from the right, question number 3. In it has only 3 periods, so the largest is lakhs period. Lakhs period have 55 lakh. 28,310. What about the last, what about the fourth question? Again you have to group into periods. It has 8 digits. So since 8 digits comes, it starts from crores. So it is 3 crore 45. After crore, which period? 45 lakh. 45 lakh. Then comes to the next period is 41 thousands. Period is just 41 thousands. What about the last 3 digit? It is 000. So no need to represent that. So we did first 4 questions of the first question of exercise 1.1. The remaining 4 questions are homework. I'll give that number in your group with your homework questions. Now move to the next question. Question number B. Write the numbers and mark the period with commas. Write the numbers. Write the numbers and mark the periods with commas. Which is the first question for that? 7 lakh 22,000 142. So you have to write the numbers, write the numerals. Which is the largest period given here? It is 7 lakh. So it is 7 lakh. Only 7 lakhs period have only 1 digit and 1 number. It is 7. So you have to write 7 lakh. Put a comma. Then coming to the thousands period have 2 digits and the number given here is 22. So you write 22, then put comma, then coming to the ones period is 142. 7,22,142. Then coming to the second question, it is 235,5,230. Okay, how will you write the numeral for this one? In the lakhs period, we have two digits, and here it is 35 in the lakhs period. So you put 35, put comma. Now for the next one, thousands period.
Thousands period.
For the thousands period, we need two. We need two digits in the thousands period, but we are here the number given is 5. So this 5 have to be represented as 05, and then to the last period it is 213. 213, you know how to write 213. And now the last question. 5 crore 12 lakh 16,000 16,000 16,000 7. Children, please mute your audio. 16,705 705 705. And how will you write the numeral for this one? It has crores period. So crores period, the digit, the number given is 5. So you put 5. Since after each period you have to put comma, after 5 you have to put comma. Lakhs period have two digits and the number given in the lakhs period is 12. It is 12, comma. Thousands period, now coming to the next period, is thousands period, have 16 in the thousands period. And the last, in the ones period is 705. So 705 you can write like this. So which is the last one? 5 crore 12 lakh 16,705. So children, we can stop the maths class, today's maths class now. We did exercise 1.1A, question number A, 4 questions, and question number B, 3 questions. I think you all wrote in your rough book. I'll give the notes so that these questions also will be there. And the remaining questions of exercise 1.1A and B of page 9 are homework questions. Homework, page 9, exercise 1.1 A, 5 6 7 8, not clear, 1 2 3, in the notebook, in the fair notebook, after the notes, okay. Thank you, children. Hope you understood all the topics that we discussed today. Thank you and have a nice day.